Job interviewers of Reddit, what are some things people do because they think it will impress you, but actually have the opposite effect? Had a student applying for an entry-level IT internship. His resume said he was fluent in Cantonese and Mandarin. Just for fun, I decided to check. I'm a randomly fluent white guy. He did not, in fact, speak any Mandarin at all. Still hired him, and turned out to be one of my best interns ever. But it did raise a red flag that was entirely avoidable. Mayo, what a surprise ending. I probably never would have hired someone who lied that boldly. Only happened once, but when I asked a guy about going above and beyond to make a customer happy, he told me a story about him breaking the rules at a construction site to let two teenagers write their names in the concrete. One of my friends, who was previously the store's assets protection executive, asked the same question. And the idiot said he gave the customer back extra change at the register. We were hiring for a teacher position and I was one of five in the panel. Our school color is red. This guy, 22 years old, straight out of college, came in the color red. Literally in red. Red hair, red eyebrows, complete red suit and tie, red shoes with a red resume. It was difficult not to laugh. I wasn't the interviewer, just the one who processed the applications and called them to confirm the interviews. I had someone tell me I don't know anything because my dad never made me work right after I invited her for an interview. She was bragging. That seems pretty random. Throwing around technical jargon that is meant to go over the head of the interviewer and impress them, I guess. It's only happened one time, but it was very memorable because my background is engineering, not sales, and I don't believe the candidate bothered to look up my LI profile. So I was very aware that he was misusing terms and confusing technologies in an attempt to show how smart he was. He wasn't. The other interviewer was impressed with how much he knew until I explained it was all a bunch of well-worded, but wrong bulls, and if he did that in front of a client, he'd have zero credibility. Advice: stay in your lane and talk to the job you're applying for. Pulling out your phone. A lady who was applying to be a delivery driver was interviewing with me and I asked her if she's ever done any volunteering. We're very involved with the community, running drives and fundraisers and stuff. She pulls out her phone to scroll through her Instagram feed to her picture from 3 years ago. Over 5 minutes of silence and she finally gets to the picture, which was her twerking on a baby elephant at a wildlife sanctuary. Don't ever pull out your phone during interview, for one, and especially don't show your potential future boss an almost naked picture of your butt for two. Comma twerking on a baby elephant. I think you missed out. Name dropping someone they know that works at the company, not a reference. I've sat in on a couple interviews where the interviewee dropped the name of an employee and it was someone who isn't well liked. I was part of an interview process where the candidate name dropped someone at the company who happened to be in the room. That did not go well for them. Dumb business buzzwords. Hear them all the time and they just make you look like you were churned out of a factory. Be genuine. During an interview for a permanent, full-time position, I asked a candidate the relatively standard "where do you see yourself in X years?" question. Her response, in a very bragging tone, was, "Well, my husband is doing very well for himself and is planning to take early retirement in 5 months, so when he retires we'll both be retiring and moving to the south of France. Yeah, I'm not going to employ someone for a permanent role. That requires a month of training. Who's going to hang around for 5 months maximum? So I guess don't do that." To answer a couple of common questions. 1. That's a dumb question. Surely I was working through a series of standard questions the company expected us to ask candidates, so I literally had no choice but to ask it. Regardless, it's an okay question for some roles. They might want to see that your ambitions fit with company goals, or they might just want to see that you've actually thought about it. 2. What's the correct response? This depends on the role in question. There's no perfect answer and it's more about how you answer the question. Usually talking about developing your skills, mentioning doing a couple of responsibilities that aren't in the job spec but are probably in the next level up, or frankly any response that implies you'll still be someone we want to employ. Avoid being too ambitious. "I'm going to be your boss by then." Avoid implying you'll be leaving for certain, and avoid saying that you will be exactly the same as you are now. I'm expecting to train and develop you to some extent. If you're expecting to get no better at doing a job in 5 years, that's a massive red flag. Bragging, interrupting, going off on tangents to tell stories. Just answer the questions clearly and competently and you'll do well. Using the phrase at my level. Complimenting me, interrupting before I'm finished with the question, telling me personal stories, information completely unrelated. I made fun of the fact that the interviewer was from NJ. What exit did you live off? Wanted to impress her with a good old insult from back home. Didn't work. Oh man, I'm a recruiter, so that's literally all I do all day. I had a man brag to me about going above and beyond by doing extra at work because women don't think they should have to do things themselves. I'm a woman. I had a woman tell me she's such a hard worker, unlike this new, lazy generation. I'm a millennial. I had an Asian woman at an old job talk to my boss that was in the interview with us and was trying to make it seem like she works so well with all different people and tried to show this by asking my black boss what his favorite flavor of Kool-Aid is and where he gets his soul food. It used to crack me up how many middle-aged, or older, people sat across the desk from me asking for a job while simultaneously talking about how lazy our generation is. You just know they go home talking about age discrimination when we don't hire them. Dang. I missed that last block of text the first time I read through your comment. That's unbelievable. Advice to interviewers moaning about people coming too early. Don't change the time of the interview. Let them wait. It doesn't have to disturb your schedule at all, and it could be that they had a transport choice of being too early or not being sure if they would be on time. Remember, they don't really know the commute yet. Also, they just might want to get a feel for the place while they calm their nerves and prepare. I once asked a girl what the best constructive criticism she'd ever received was. She answered by telling me a long story about how one of her high school teachers told her that she was a follower, not a leader. Which apparently upset her so much that she whipped off a novel of an email to the teacher explaining all of the things that she felt made her a leader. Her tone throughout the entire answer was one of absolute disbelief, like she was shocked and disgusted that someone dared call her a follower over 4 years ago. She clearly thought it was a great answer that illustrated her willingness to stand up for herself and be a leader, but all I heard was that she completely misunderstood my question. Was unable to think of any actual examples of constructive criticism in her life. Something a student in a creative major should have tons of, and roundly rejected criticism given to her by her superiors. So, don't do that. Actually listen to the questions the interviewer is asking you, and then answer them. I'm friends with the person who interviews for jobs at our technology company, and the conversation goes as follows. Him. So on a scale to 1-10, how good would you say your knowledge level about phones are? Interviewee. 10. Him. Okay, great. So tell me what you know about Apple products. Interviewee. I'm not sure. I've never worked with an Apple phone before. Him. Okay. What kind of phone do you use? Interviewee. I don't even know. It's some type of Android. Denied for the job. Maybe they thought 10 was at the bottom of the scale. Ignore the woman who is also interviewing you, and answer her questions while looking at me, and direct all your questions at me. Interviewers often have BS culture fit conversations, but I've found just giving people common opportunities to be in but, like including a diverse set of interviewers, is plenty to find out who you really don't want to work with. Rambling. Dear God, the rambling. They'll just go on and on and on with an unrelated answer to your question. Sometimes it's okay just not to have an answer. Also the button-up suit coat. It's weird, guys. It's weird. Bashing their previous current company. I don't know why some people do it, but it's very unbecoming. When asked the question of why did you leave your previous position, don't say because you hated your boss or that it was a terrible place to work, or go on a long drawn-out rant that ended with HR firing you. I've luckily only been in this position twice. Both times I was honest about the problems, but phrased it there were lots of things about the job I really enjoyed, such as X, Y, Z, but in the end the issue of N became too big and we weren't able to resolve it. I've had interviews where the hopeful candidate starts bragging about doing something illegal when she was younger. In general, don't talk to me like we're buddies at a bar together. Also, I'm not impressed by yes men. Don't just regurgitate back to me what you think I want to hear. I want to hear your own thoughts as well as you can articulate them, and provide specific examples. And if you are having trouble with a question, just politely ask me to rephrase, or provide an example. I used to do interviews for a retail store. Had a girl come in 1 hour late, hiring for overnight, and let her interview anyway because we needed warm bodies. She told me she was late because she had to wait for her boyfriend to sober up, weed, then later bragged about not doing work at her old job. That's a no from me. Not asking questions. I'm not sure if people do it because they are worried they will look dumb or if they are trying to project confidence, but I have never hired someone that didn't themselves ask a lot of good questions during their interview. If someone is not considered for a second interview, I'll send them a friendly rejection notice that lets them know we hired someone else and then wish them luck in their job search. There are people who have replied to these like, well, I have an interview at place this week and they offer more than you put in your job description. Okay, is that supposed to impress me or make me regret not hiring you? Also, there's something to be said for persistence, but if you're rejected multiple times, please stop calling on the status of your application or calling to demand an interview. Which is sadly why when I do get rejected, I either A. never get officially notified of it, or B. people sound like they're terrified to tell me, and it's probably because of the crazies out there. I ain't mad HR. I just want to know so I can move on, or learn from the experience what you guys didn't like. I had a guy do a 30-minute Skype video interview without a shirt on. I guess he thought he had an excellent body, but since it was for a software developer position, it didn't matter. He didn't get the job. Your loss, man. You just missed out on a chance to hire a developer with really great abs. I know someone who had to audition actors. One of them showed up with his brother, who was a minor celebrity. Said semi-famous brother popped his head into the audition room to say hello. Yep, didn't win the guy a part. No one gives a crap your brother was semi-famous. I work in network security. If you interview with me, don't admit to multiple felonies during the interview. I am sure you hacked AOL in 1994 to get all the leftover minutes in your state and were able to hack our Wi-Fi from the parking lot. We don't have Wi-Fi, and he had used the default password to someone in the apartment complex behind us. Bet you he carried around a spare keyboard to hack twice as fast. People like to BS answers to questions. I guess they think it makes us think they know their stuff. The reality is that here in IT, if you go through a whole interview and don't say I don't know, but this is how I'd find out, you're probably not getting hired. We can tell when you're BSing a technical question. Implying that working in IT isn't all about Googling how stuff works. I've interviewed people before that apparently got too comfortable with me while we were talking, because they started swearing and telling inappropriate stories like it would make them more relatable. Until you actually know your boss better, aka not before the interview is over. Don't drop the professional act, especially if you're faking it. My co-manager and I interviewed a man for a supervisor position who was obviously qualified for the position, and he knew it. Every question we asked him, he would give an unexpected answer, then explain his answer and connect it back to the question in a roundabout way. Every answer he gave took at least 5 minutes of explaining, because he was trying to be clever. Luckily it was a phone interview, so the entire time my co-manager and I were looking at each other like, what the frick is this guy talking about? He would have been a shoo-in for the job if he would have just answered questions normally. It's been several years ago, so I can't remember any of the specific questions or answers, but they were over the top ridiculous, and he was 100% serious about them. Holy crap, be to the point people. Talking fatigue is a real thing. I may bust out one or two twisty-turny answers, but they are for the more personal questions, and I'm looking for a chuckle with how I tell the story. The technical job-related questions get direct answers, more if asked for more. I'm terrible at interviews. I filled out my first application at 17. The boss came out to talk with me. Small town. Everyone knows everyone. Asked if I realized I had spelled my name wrong. I put out a dozen resumes before I realized I put my old phone number on them. It happens to the best of us. It seems like a lot of interviewers ask questions that might be more suited to be asked by a sociologist or a psychologist. I'm not sure they are even interpreting the answers correctly. Might be best to ask straightforward job-related questions, as opposed to if you were a tree questions. I ask my interviewees to talk about a time they had a conflict with a co-worker, and to tell me how they navigated that situation. I've had more than one person respond that the conflict they had was being more qualified than their supervisor, and then proceed to tell me how hard it was to work for someone who doesn't know as much as they do. I know that happens sometimes, but it's not a great way to answer that question. I never have a good answer to that question because I pretty much get along with everyone as long as I try to. When people ask me that, I know I look like a deer in the headlights, but it's a terrible question to say. I'm not sure I have an answer to that too. My biggest pet peeve is what I call the wee weasel. I hire mostly engineers, technicians, etc. If I ask what candidates did during a previous position and they talk about how we did X, I ask follow-ups to determine what pieces they actually did and what they contributed. If I can't get to that answer, it's a no-go. Stop trying to take credit for the entire world and tell me what you can actually do. Telling me about how they called into a conference call at work when they were in the IQ, or some other crazy situation, to show their dedication. I want humans, not robots. And I don't want competition within my team to see who can sacrifice more of their personal life, health, family, relationship, whatever, trying to impress a corporation that will lay them off the second they need to pump earnings. When I was first out of college and looking for a job, an older person told me I ought to print out a stack of resumes and walk into every company in my town that is related to my industry and introduce myself. After working for several years now, I see that's a pretty terrible idea. We are busy during the day. We aren't even hiring most of the time anyway. If you want to do something like that, please send us an email. You give me a paper resume, I can guarantee it's going in the trash as soon as I get back to my office. If you try to make it cute or something crazy like 7 pages, we will actually pass it around the office, but probably not in the way you intended for us to. I've been a recruiter for about 8 years. I don't have a great answer for this question because I really try to take my interviews in stride at this point. I sometimes find myself judging petty things, and I've been trying to check that. Whether nerves, awkwardness, or bad advice, which is plentiful, people do say crazy things in interviews, but so do hiring managers and, admittedly, recruiters. Something that worked for someone one time with one audience isn't necessarily going to work with another. I think we all just need to respect the individual in the interview and value the fact that they have a different worldview. Sorry if that's not the intended response. Just my take after thousands of interviews. You probably haven't experienced this because you're HR, but insert answer. Alternate version include you've never had to. You probably don't know what I'm talking about, and my personal favorite, you're just HR, so let me overly explain like you're 3 years old. Bruh, we met 3 minutes ago and you already know my life story. I bet you also know how this interview is going to end too. I haven't run across this one being mentioned yet. People who engage in some variety of cyber stalking. Dude, connection requests on LinkedIn, FB, Twitter, Insta, and then quoting things to me in a cold email from the blog that I once had years and years ago doesn't make me wanna hire you. It makes you freaking creepy. Acting like a big shot or being rude to my admin assistant instead of being polite. A smile and thank you go a very long way. She has a lot of influence in my hiring decisions. I respect her, appreciate everything she does to help me, and rely on her judgment. She coordinates with the candidate and others to set everything up, meets the candidate in the lobby to bring him her into a conference room, offers water, coffee, etc. When she's asking pleasant questions, she's getting a read on the candidate. She has more touch points with the candidate than I do. After everything is done and she's shown the candidate out, I ask her what her impressions are. Even if a candidate nailed the interview with myself and my colleagues, if she was rude to her, then it's over. Happens more than one might think. About a year ago, my exec chef was hiring a new SOS. When asked what his weaknesses were, this one candidate say he had no weaknesses. My boss just straight up said there was no way he could work with someone like that. Haha. Overconfidence. I have found that people who are not or even a little nervous turn out to be insane. It's normal to be nervous. My biggest weakness is that I get too involved in my work and it's hard to focus on something else. Ugh. Rolls eyes. I use this question to gauge honesty. If you tell me you suck at math or can't count your ABCs without singing the song, I'll know you're a truthful person. I can tell when an answer is a cop-out and someone is trying to tell me something they think I want to hear. Good examples of answers, IMO, are being bad at public speaking, on-the-spot math. To answers I read in the replies here, didn't attend or complete college, overly stressed when projects have a deadline, unable to handle heavy workloads, the inability to keep personal problems from affecting your work life. If someone tells me that last one especially, I respect them for not being afraid to tell me the truth. It gauges honesty and it'd rather hire an honest person than a liar. What else could they have lied about on their application or resume? Show up super early. Not that it has the opposite effect, but I'm interviewing like 6 people in a day. If your time is 2 p.m. and you show up at 1, I'm likely still talking to someone else. People entering the workforce after leaving the military tend to have this problem. The military culture is that if you're 15 minutes early, you're already late. The professional mindset that I've encountered is more akin to anything more than 5 minutes early is time wasted that could have been spent working. Had a candidate today that replied to, so, you had a chance to look through our website and take a look at what we do, right? Did you want me to clarify anything with yes? I did, but I'd love to hear it from you. I work in design and I always ask this question to candidates. On a scale of 1-10, 10 being excellent, how would you rate your Photoshop Illustrator skills? And more often than I would have ever thought, especially when I interviewed candidates for an internship, they would say some number above 10. I quickly would always reply with, wow, you would rate your skill as a 15? I mean, I don't even consider myself an 8. You should be teaching me since there's nothing I could really teach you here in this internship. It's amazing how quickly they try to backtrack. Moral of the story, you can always learn more and get better. Personal tics. Once saw a girl in an interview get so nervous that she kept reaching up to pick her nose and then suddenly she would catch herself and put the booger in her mouth, suddenly hoping that nobody would notice. Don't let your nervousness get to the point that you are doing things that are more distracting than the answers you are giving to the questions being posed to you. Don't pick your nose and eat your boogers. Got it? After the interview, calling every single day to see if they got the job. A thank you and a follow-up call are great, but don't demonstrate just how annoying you will be to have around. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.